Hey guys, my name is Richie, and today's video I'm going to be reviewing the season 3 finale of Continuum.
Once there was a boy who lived on the farm.
Alec launches Halo. It changes everything.
That boy had a dream that nobody believed in.
Tomorrow you'll become the next Steve Jobs.
You wanted to make a difference. You do this and you never get back home to your future, your family. I am that boy, and Halo is that dream. This timeline isn't big enough for the both of us.
And I want to start off by saying that I really loved the episode. It opened the door for a lot of possibilities for a season 4. Overall, it was kind of satisfying. Like, if the series ended there, I would have been okay, because in the season 3 finale, Kira, you know, she finally accepts the possibility of not returning to the year 2077, I believe. I forgot. But her timeline, you know, she finally accepts that, you know, she might not make it back there. Because, you know, all these timelines and parallel things and all the stuff that happened between... Because, you know, Alec went back in the past and... Or I should say future Alec. I don't know. It's a lot of confusion stuff because there's time travel. You know how Alec and Kira went back to the past to prevent something. They kind of created a paradox. And there's a lot of things. It's a lot of time travel. Like, jibber-jabber stuff, you know. It's kind of confusing to explain that stuff. But because of all that stuff, you know, happening and... You know, it kind of like shines, you know, Kira's possibility of going back to the future. And, you know, it was really nice to see her moving on. I mean, she even has a love interest, the guy who basically killed her in the last timeline or this timeline. I don't know. Like I said, it's really confusing when there's time travel, you know, involved in explaining stuff. But, yeah, we see her finally accept this and she's ready to... You know, move forward and stay there, make a life. And seeing Alec, like, not become the Alec that he was in the future or the other timeline, whatever, because we basically see the future Kellogg is basically the new Alec in some ways. It's kind of confusing. Like I said, it's a lot of time travel, jibber jabber stuff. But yeah, it was really cool to see, like, an older version of Kellogg, because we always see, you know, a future Alec, like the old Alec and, you know, all that. We don't really see Kellogg. We see, like, a flashback of Kellogg, I think, in season 2, I believe, or was it season 3? I'm not really sure, but, like, seeing a future version of Kellogg, like, you know, him older and all that. So it's kind of cool to see how Kellogg's plan of taking over and, you know, becoming rich, I guess it really happens eventually, because it looks like he has a lot of power in that timeline. And it's crazy. And then how Kellogg took over Alec's business, I'm like, whoa! And Alec is like really pissed off because Kellogg did this behind his back, or his other version of him. Because remember, there were two Alecs in this timeline, the one... They came from the future, and then the one that was in that timeline. I know, like I said, it's a little confusing, but to see Kellogg plan this and he wanted to take over Alec's business, I'm like, whoa! You know, that's really crazy and really smart of Kellogg, because I always saw Kellogg as a very smart person. Even though he was one of my favorite characters, like, now I'm just like, wow. Wow, Kellogg. I mean, I can understand he was doing this to the present Alec, because the present Alec was kind of a douchebag. But yeah, in some ways I'm really proud of Kellogg, because he was able to take over the company of present Alec. But, you know, when future Alec took over, then I was like, damn, Kellogg, because, you know, the present Alec did, you know, screw over Kellogg, and then Kellogg had to, like, you know, sue present Alec, and he eventually got a seat in the board and stuff, and he got a percentage of the company, whatever. I'm not really sure. I don't know all the fine details, guys. Like I said, talking time travel, it's really confusing. So if you guys don't watch the show, or you guys are, like, behind and stuff, you guys are probably a little confused. But, yeah, seeing that's crazy, and seeing future Alec kill present Alec, I was just like, whoa! And a lot of stuff happened this episode, which I thought was pretty awesome. It was pretty epic. And the finale, the actual final scene of this episode kind of ended off like in a cliffhanger. Like, we don't know what exactly is happening and, like, what's going to happen to, you know, Kira and the rest of the people from the future. Like I said, there's, like, a lot of time travel stuff. I have to find, like, a specific term for each person, because they're from, like, kind of, like, different timelines, because I guess a new timeline was created because of paradox of future Alec and future Kira going to the past and changing stuff. Like I said, it's a lot of stuff and time travel, jibber jabber stuff. But yeah, I'm gonna have to rate this episode a 9.5 out of 10. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Like, what were your thoughts about the season 3 finale of Continuum? Did you guys like it? Did you guys hate it? Because I really thought it was a really good finale. Like, if that was the series finale, I would be kind of satisfied because it didn't really end off in a huge cliffhanger. But I would like to see a season 4 because I love the cast. I would love to see the story evolve and expand. And I'm a huge fan of Continuum, and I really hope it gets renewed. So just cross your fingers. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really, really appreciate it. If you guys are new, subscribe. It's free. It should be somewhere up here or down here, over here, over here. I'm not really sure because YouTube is always changing stuff or moving stuff around. And thank you for watching, and bye.